It's review time! Here we go, another package for review. By the way, if you are sending stuff in for review, DHL is really probably the best method if you can, because you can send it into my post office box. Sorry, DHL. You can send it to my post office box, and it's much quicker than trying to send it to my home address, because if I'm not there, the courier leaves a card, and then I've got to go and track it down, and it takes an extra couple of days if you don't send it to my post office box. And there's my post office box for those who want to know what it is. Not going to hide my address. There you go. Let's have a look inside. Let's see what's in this thing. Woohoo! An unbagging. It's a box. There you go. Yeah. Okay. All right. Get my next tool, and we'll open the box. We're not going to unbox. We're just going to open the box. I think I know what this might be. For all you FPVers, this will be of interest. And if you're not an FPVer, you should be, because it's so much fun. Here we go. Ooh, look. Ah, some cameras from Foxeer. What have we got? Predator. And Predator Micro. What's this one? This is a Foxeer Falcor Micro. This is a Foxeer Predator version 3 Micro. Foxeer Falcor Mini 1200. There's a lot. Stickers! Yes! Foxeer, thank you. Stickers, everyone loves stickers. What else have we got in here? There is a 5.8 gig patch feeder header. Now that's going to be interesting. FPV antenna. Try that one out. And this is a lollipop antenna, one of the Foxeer lollipops. And best of all, bubble wrap. Everyone loves bubble wrap. Yay! I'll save it for later. It's nearly Christmas. I'll give that to someone as a present. So we've got quite a bit of a lineup here from Foxeer to review. Let me just pan down a bit so we can actually see a bit better. Right, so we've got one. Presume that's a camera. There we go. So there is a fair bit of kit here for me to take a look at and review, which I will be doing. In fact, I may review one of these things right now. Let's see what happens. Okay, let's start by taking a look at this, the Foxeer Echo. It is a circularly polarized patch antenna. It claims to have 8 decibels of gain, which is quite a bit. I haven't worked it out, but 10 decibels is 10 times, 3 decibels is twice, 6 decibels is 4 times. So it's probably about 7.5 times the gain. Well, not quite 7.5 times the gain, but let's say, 6 times the gain of one of these conventional just circularly polarized omnidirectional antenna. So this should give us a useful increase in distance. If we're using this on our goggles and we point our head in the right direction, we should get a reasonable increase in distance, which is quite useful, especially if you're flying proximity through trees or whatever, or you're just flying fixed wing and you want to go a bit further, then something like this can make quite a difference. Now, its biggest competitor is the antenna that I tend to use a lot, which is the 5-turn helical. And you can see, let's move the packaging out of the way. Let's take a look at the difference in size between these two antennas. There's a huge difference. There's our little circular patch with 8 decibels. Here's our helical, which has probably got a decibel or two more gain, but look how much bigger that is. Another thing with the helical, I had to fix this one the other day, because just down here where the wire solders onto the spiral, the solder joint had broken. So I was trying to figure out, why am I not getting the range I usually get with this antenna? Something's wrong. I had a quick look, and there was the problem. Soldered it up good as gold. But it shows you that it is very easy to damage a helical if you're putting it in and out of your pack all the time, like I tend to do. This, tough as old boots, by the look of it, it's molded in plastic. It's got a short semi-rigid coax with an SMA connector. That's going to fit really nicely on a set of goggles. In fact, I'll throw them on my goggles and see how they look. There you go. There's the Omways I quite often use. And you can see it's a nice, compact little setup. And yeah, if it provides the necessary gain and it has a wide enough beam for the amount of gain it gives, this could be a really great alternative to the much longer and therefore more easily bent or disturbed or pointed in the wrong direction helical. So what I've done is I've set up a test rig. Let's go and have a look at that. And it's about to pee down with rain. Okay, so here's the setup. Excuse the wind noise if there's any, but we're lucky it's not raining, it's spring. I've got the DVR here, I've got the Foxeer tiny, tiny patch on the top here. I'm going to fly down here. Let me just pan around so you can see where we're going. We're going to fly way down there, and we're going to compare the performance of this new Foxeer antenna to a standard pagoda antenna,
and to perhaps a 5-tune helical and just see if it's really the 8 decibels that are claimed for it, and also how it handles things like the multi-pathing from the metallic hangers, which if I pan around a bit further, you can see these metallic hangers produce a lot of multi-pathing, so we'll tell how well it's circularly polarized. It should be quite a good test. So without further ado, let's get on with it.
Okay, to get a baseline for these tests, I use their Aomwe cloverleaf antenna here, 4-lobe cloverleaf antenna. It's a really, it's one of the best omnidirectionals on the market. So this was put on the DVR, and I'm going to fly the same course with 3 antennas. So we've got that Omni is the first one to give us a baseline reference for a non-directional antenna. And I've got to say that the quad I used is the Cicada 180. Now, unfortunately, it's got a CMOS camera, older generation CMOS camera, and the sky conditions here are the worst possible for CMOS. So the picture is really, really crap. Also, I had had a crash earlier on. You'll see that at the end of the video here. I had had a bit of a problem earlier on. You might see it at the beginning of the video. I can't remember where I put it. But so it did have some mush on the lens. Basically, I crashed into long grass and it got some muck on the lens, which I didn't wipe off, so it's not a very sharp image. But that's not important, because what we're looking at here is the amount of noise, the amount of noise on the signal, and things such as multipathing, which tells us how good an antenna is. So here we go. This is a pass of the course with the omnidirectional antenna. Now, as we move down here, you can see the occasional flickering. That's multipathing off those hangers, off the metal buildings. So obviously there's a certain amount of rejection from the Aomwe. It's pretty good. And here we're getting a bit of a loss of signal. It's starting to get a bit black and white. It picks up again as we fly through the Fresnel zone and so forth. By the end of the runway, there's a lot of snow on that picture. So we've got quite a bit of noise. There's not a lot of gain. There's virtually no gain in the cloverleaf antenna. And coming back here, things get really, really bad. That's partly because with this quad, when you are facing forwards, or when it's flying towards you, the battery tends to shield the antenna somewhat. But you see, really, really poor signal through there. That's quite bad combination of Fresnel zone and antenna placement on the quad, and so forth. It picks up as we get closer, as you'd expect. But then we get the multipathing off those buildings again. So this Aomwe, you know, it works really well for a omnidirectional antenna, but you know, there are limitations. Now I'm going to fly past the DVR, which is on the right there. You notice that, you know, not much difference when you fly past because it's omnidirectional. But again, when we turn around, because of the antenna placement on the drone itself, the picture gets pretty crappy, but it's still enough to fly. It's perfectly good. There's no problems there. We can fly that around pretty well. And that's the end of that one. And this time we'll look at the Foxeer, what is it, the Echo, is it? Foxeer Echo? Yeah, or something like that. This tiny, tiny antenna. Is it going to be, well, obviously it should be better than the Omni, but when you look at it, it's actually not much bigger. So how do they get all that extra signal? If they do, let's have a look. So off we go now. One thing I noticed is it doesn't seem to be as much multipathing from those buildings. It's a fairly steady signal along here as we fly the same path. Those flickers, we're not getting those flickers. A little bit there, but you know, it's a lot less multipathing. That's partly because we have a more directional antenna. It's got a beam, so it's ignoring stuff coming in from the side. Now we get right down. Notice the signal's still pretty clean. There's a bit of noise, but nowhere near as much as with the Omni. And we're turning around here. That's still quite a clean signal. And now we're facing forwards. I'm surprised we should get a dropout, but there we go. That's a dropout caused by the antenna placement. But look, it's still a much cleaner signal apart from these occasional dropouts here. Let's wait till we get past that piece of the Fresnel zone. There we go. Now we're back into nice, relatively clean signal. So it's definitely the antenna has some gain. Obviously it's got gain because it's giving us a better picture. Now we're coming back into the area where the hangers are, and we've had one kind of dropout. There's a few more. You'll never get away from that. There's always going to be that multipathing, and circular polarization only reduces it, cannot eliminate it. But look, that's a lovely fine picture. I'm going to fly past the antenna, the DVR. We're going into the back of it now, and we can see the signal starting to drop off. You know, there we go, and it's dropping off. It's getting pretty bad now. So it definitely is gain out one side, no gain out the other. In fact, it's worse than the omnidirectional back this way. So there we go, we come back. Now, I thought I'd do something else here. I thought I'd fly out over the paddock at right angles to the DVR. I'll just come back here a little bit so I can line up. Fly back at right angles to the DVR to check what the side lobe performance is like. And that's quite important because, you know, obviously you're not going to always be flying in front. You may not turn your head properly. So we're now flying out to the side of the antenna, and we're getting a lot of multipathing and Fresnel stuff. There we go. We're starting to break up. It's, but we have got a surprising amount of good quality image out the side. Now we're getting into a null point. It's not as good, obviously, as the Omni. We're getting over here. It's getting all noisy again. So it definitely has some side lobes and a main lobe. And if you get between them, you can lose signal, but that's true of any directional antenna. Now we're back on the beam and she's all good as gold. Look at that, probably 150 meters or so that we're away there. And again, a little bit of that multipathing, but no, it definitely is an antenna with gain. It's got more performance than the omnidirectional if you're looking to go in a straight line. So that is the Fox Ear Echo. At this stage, I'm pretty impressed. But let's compare it to, where are we? My 5-turn helical that I use quite often. Okay, here we are, heading back down, get myself sorted. Nice, crisp, clean picture. The helicals do have really excellent gain down the beam. No real sign of multipathing, which is another benefit of helicals. Look at this, getting a bit noisy here, though. There's a bit of dropout here as we go through the Fresnel zone. We're down at the limit of, or where I decide to stop, and there's more noise when I do that turn. It's probably, yeah, there we go, we're dipping out again. So all of the antennas dipped out as we started coming back for various reasons, but the 5-turn helical, I think, has a little more gain, perhaps. I think it has a little more gain. It should be the same gain, but I think it's just got a little bit more. And as we come through here, we're getting only a minor amount of multipathing from those buildings. You know, the performance is pretty good. I like the 5-turn helicals. Now let's fly past the DVR here, which is just on the right now, and we'll see what is working behind. Notice we're getting more flickering here, but I was actually quite surprised at how much we got behind the 5-turn helical. It's actually working really well behind, which is a huge surprise to me, because it should not give us very much of a signal at all. It works really well, so I'm thinking, Now then I decided, let's see how the helical performs when you fly out to the side. So here we go, we're flying directly at right angles to the helical, and basically it doesn't. We lost the signal pretty much now, and at this stage, pretty shortly, the DVR just decides to stop. It's had enough. It's not going to record anymore because there's not enough signal. So let's summarise what we've found with this little test. Well, the Fox Ear patch antenna, I think it's really kind of good. I've never been a fan of these little patches in the past because some of them have been pretty poor. And if you look at something like this, these things here, these are just terrible. This claims to have a 14 decibel gain. Nah. And it's not circularly polarised. It's just a linear patch. So you don't get the benefits of circular polarisation with a patch like this. These, yeah, I wouldn't use them. The helical, brilliant, as you saw in the test video. It has more gain than this, but that's to be expected. It is certainly has some benefits, but if you want to fly out, you've got to keep your head pointed in the right direction with your helical because it has a narrower beam. And if you fly out the side of the helical, as we saw in that video, the signal just disappears in a very short space of time. You lose all your signal and you're basically, you know, you will have a problem. Whereas the Fox Ear patch, yes, sure, the signal out the side was reduced, as you would expect with an antenna that has directionality, but it certainly has enough side lobe capacity to mean that you don't have to have your head pointed directly at the model at all times. And this is a trade-off with antenna gain. The more gain, the more directional. Less gain, less directional. I was surprised, though, that I could fly behind this helical and get such good results. It may have been that we had some reflections going on. There may have been something. There was an aircraft sitting pretty much in front of this antenna, and maybe that aircraft was reflecting signal back to the helical, so it was compensating for the lack of directionality or the lack of pickup in the back. I don't know. This was a fairly impromptu test, so we can only draw some rough figures from this. I'm going to go back and test these things thoroughly. I'm going to put them on some gear, going to measure the amount of signal that they get, which is really important because this subjective stuff, it's fine, but there are a lot of variables that we can't really compensate for. So we'll do a full antenna, a reshoot out. Remember, I did an antenna video some time ago where I compared pagodas and all sorts of things for their gain, their cross-polarization capabilities, you know, how well they were polarized, all that sort of stuff. I'm going to do it again. So if you're a manufacturer or a vendor that's selling antennas, send me some antennas, I'll test them. We'll put them up against the best. If you think your antennas are really tickety-boo, well, we'll try them out and see if they're the best thing since sliced bread. Right, so there we go. And of course, you've got your omnidirectional like this or the Aomwe, and they give you the best all-round close-in flying experience. But, you know, as I say, if you're flying through bushes and trees or want to go a bit further, you do need some gain. And I am impressed with that antenna. That I'm going to put that on my goggles. I'll keep this in my pack, but I'm going to use this most of the time. I'll use the Fox Ear most of the time because it just seems to provide a really nice trade-off between directionality and extra gain. So I think they've hit a sweet spot with this thing. But I will tell you in a later video because I'm going to go and do as much flying with this as I can. You'll probably see some videos popping up with me doing some casual park flying, and just I might do a couple of flights with this and a couple of flights with the helical, and we'll just compare them. It's really up to you. If you value space, then this is obviously, it's much smaller, much more compact, much less easy to break. So that's it for this video. Now, I did have some other antennas come in from Fox Ear, these ones, the little lollipop antennas. And as I've said before, these I wasn't very impressed with in their early incarnation, not necessarily the Fox Ear ones, but some of the first ones of these that came out were pretty poor. The one that's on the Holybro, latest Holybro quad I reviewed, the Copus 2 SE, that worked really well. So I'm going to try these. I have a feeling that they may have perfected these. These might work really well as well. So this is for your goggles. This is for your model. We'll do some tests and we'll pair those up and see if they work really well together. I'm pretty sure they'll work. Not too bad at all. So there you go. That's it. Disclosure as always, this was provided for review by Fox Air. I didn't have to pay for this, but if it was crap, I would have told you. As you see in many of my reviews, I tell you when it's crap, even if it means that the company's concerned, probably won't send me anything else. But this is good. I like it. Right, enough rambling from me. Questions, comments in the usual place, please. I will do my best to answer them. In the meantime, thank you for watching, and I do apologise for the poor DVR footage and the really crappy lighting conditions for this review, but it is now peeing down outside. Our spring is taking a long time to transition into summer. Summer starts tomorrow in the Southern Hemisphere, but it sure doesn't look like it. There you go. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. And here we go, flying down towards the far end of the runway. It's getting very, very snowy here. This is, getting signal dropout. I've gone past the end of the tarmac. Whoa, getting very signal lossy here. Let me turn around. That's a bit better. And probably 400 metres away now. One thing I forgot here was that the contour of the land blocks the signal when you go over this side. And, yes. Uh-oh. My spotter said, look out, you're going to disappear behind the hill. And guess what happened? Look, this is what happened. Nothingness. Lots and lots of nothingness. Sadly, I'm afraid, So I spent half an hour trying to find the quad. But fortunately, thanks to the FreeSky telemetry, it's not that hard. FreeSky telemetry is brilliant for finding things. So I found it in knee-high long grass in about half an hour, which includes the 400 metres walking to find it and the 400 metres walking back.